Two deadly floods in less than 2 years. Today, a new plan is revealed aimed at protecting Ellicott City. Nicole joins us now with the details in the studio. Nicole.
Rick, that's right. Leaders in Howard County now rededicating themselves to ensure that people, places, and things are safe and sound.
After two bouts of deadly and devastating flooding along Main Street in Ellicott City, the goal is
to retain as much of old Ellicott City's culture, charm, and history as possible.
There's a new plan to keep the historic district afloat.
To introduce state legislation to bring more state funding to the flood mitigation efforts.
Thursday, Howard County Executive Calvin Ball announced phase one of the Ellicott City Safe and Sound program. The program includes new technology for the emergency alert system, clearing debris from waterways within 14 days of a storm, improving stormwater retention in at least 9 areas, and most importantly, securing buildings along Main Street.
These properties will be assessed by a structural engineer to ensure their stability and integrity.
Taxes won't go up for this project. Money for this plan has already been accounted for. Former county executive Alan Kettleman pushed for more than a dozen buildings along Main Street to be torn down. That's something Ball so far has not committed to doing.
Therefore, my administration intends to honor the offers that have been already sent out and negotiate in good faith with those property owners to acquire the buildings and structures.
The top priority for Ball remains the safety of residents and preserving one of Howard County's most precious economic assets.
Now, the county will also offer up to $5,000 per project for flood prevention. For now, that money is only available for property owners in Old Ellicott City, Dunlogan, and Valley Mead. Rick, back to you.